My name is Olive Sia. I'm 47 years old. I've been a member of Wisdom Church of Manila since sometime in August. One morning, I was awakened by the Holy Spirit telling me of laying of hands. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning, and then I immediately took my Bible and looked for the specific verses that's discussed about laying of hands. Mark 16 verse 17 to 20, sinabi niya doon na, "And these signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover." And then yung sa verse 20, this really na-impress talaga sa akin, kasi sabi niya, "And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word through the accompanying signs." So for me, it was like, it was a command, an instruction of the Holy Spirit. Kasi parang sunod-sunod na may nagkakasakit sa bahay. So then morning, nilalagnat yung son ko, and then I called him. Sabi ko, "Patrick, are you sick?" Sabi niya, "Yes, mommy, I'm sick." May sinat, talagang mainit siya. And then sabi ko, "Okay, I will follow yung instructions sa akin ni Holy Spirit, laying of hands." And then I lay hands on him. And then I remember yung how to minister to the sick. I also added yung anointing of oil. And then while praying for him, instantly talaga, as in first time nangyari sa amin, instantly nawala yung fever niya. Tapos pinagpawisan siya. As in, instantly nawala. And then sabi niya sa akin, "Mommy, can I now go down and play?" Sabi ko, "Sure, sige, lakad ka, play ka na." And then, pagdating ng gabi, kunento ko sa daughter ko. Sabi ko, "Nika, you know what happened? Ganyan, ganito. Si Patrick got healed instantly, nawala yung fever niya." And then sabi niya sa akin, "Mommy, can you also pray for me? Because I am not feeling well. Masakit yung tiyan niya. Tapos parang, alam mo yung fatigue, stress sa school and everything. Sige, I will pray for you." And then while praying for her, may na-sense akong hindi maganda. It's like a parang oppressive spirit sa kanya. And then when dinagdagan ko siya ng, aside from healing declaration, nagdagdag ako ng casting, nag-renounce ako ng spirits. And then after noon, sabi niya sa akin, "Mommy, I feel better and lighter now. Nawala yung sakit ng tiyan ko." And then the following day, mahimbing na yung tulog niya, and then bumalik na yung appetite niyang kumain. Yun talaga parang, wow, 2 healings in a day, di ba? 2 healings in a day. While I was meditating on that, nung mga nangyari nung araw na yon, God reminded me that for you to have healing, you should have the twins. The twins are yung faith and anointing, and then yung obedience sa word ni God. Kasi morning, it was an instruction that I really have to do. And then yun nga, yung miraculously na heal yung dalawa kong anak in a day. Isa sa wrong mindset ko before, even nung baby Christian pa ako, is pagka may sakit sa bahay, normal lang yan siya eh. Dadalin mo muna sa doktor, and then saka kahihingi ng prayers pagka talagang malalang-malala na. Kailangan mo na talaga ng divine intervention. But the church teaches us yung authority as a believer. The Lord is working with us and confirming the word through the accompanying signs. First time talaga nangyari sa amin. So now, pag kami nagkakasakit sa bahay, immediately, hindi ako tatawag ng doktor. Instantly, maglilay hands kami, and we'll pray for it. When it comes to healing, I want to share and encourage, especially yung nag-a-attend ng Wisdom Church of Manila. I can testify yung sinasabi nila, pastora, nila, pastor coach, na the church has the anointing of healing and abundance. It is true, because ako mismo, I can testify to that, na experience ko yun sa family ko, healing and abundance.